गुड मॉर्निंग माई ऑल डियर क्लास 12th स्टूडेंट्स. इन द लास्ट वीडियो ऑफ अकाउंट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर बेसिस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग ऑफ दिस चैप्टर बेसिस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग वी हैव डिस्कस द टू बेसिस एक्यूरल बेसिस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग एंड कैश बेसिस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग एंड आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट इन द फर्दर क्लासेज वी विल डिस्कस द डिफरेंसेज या डिस्टिंक्शंस बिटवीन कैश बेसिस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग एंड एक्यूरल बेसिस ऑफ अकाउंटिंग. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. Basis of differences, first of all, cash basis of accounting and accrual basis of accounting. First one is recording of cash and credit transaction. As I have already told you that in the cash basis of accounting, we only write cash transactions. But in accrual basis of accounting, we write cash as well as credit transactions. Recording of incomes, same goes here. In the cash basis of accounting, we only write those incomes which are directly related to cash, yeah, which we have received in cash. But in accrual accounting, we write cash as well as accrued incomes. Okay, so let's move further. Okay. Recording of expenses. As per this basis, only those expenses are recorded which have been paid in cash. And in this, all types of expenses are being recorded. Outstanding expenses, there will be no treatment of outstanding, prepaid, accrued, unaccrued, etc. But here every transaction will be treated. Okay. Capital and revenue here we don't do any type of differences between capital and revenue item, but in this accounting accrual basis we distinguish between capital expenditure and revenue expenditure, capital items and revenue items. Cash accounting is not recognized under the Companies Act 2013, but this accounting is recognized by the Companies Act 2013. So it means every company has to adapt the accrual basis of accounting. Ascertain of correct profit or loss. This method or this basis of accounting does not give us the correct scenario, the correct situation of the business or the correct situation of or the profit and loss. But this basis gives us the correct or exact situation of the profit and loss of the firm. Suitability. This is suitable for professionals like doctors, lawyers, teachers, etc. And this is suitable for business class. Okay. Hybrid and mixed accounting means in this type of accounting we mix both the methods. Okay. This will also work for the professionals as well as doctors, lawyers, etc. With they prepare receipt and payment account and income and expenditure etc. Okay, so this was the chapter and this was the complete example of a theory chapter. So you just have to learn this chapter completely, and if you feel any doubt, any problem, any type of errors or any type of questions if there are in your mind, you can ask me and clear your doubts. Till then, bye-bye.